So it's been more than 2 years that the GoPro Fusion has been launched, and even today there is no direct solution from GoPro in order to use the GPS telemetry directly. But a few days ago I discovered that with a few steps involving a few files, we can now easily access the GPS telemetry of the GoPro Fusion, and I'm going to show you what the steps are. So the first thing that you have to do is, you'll have to install the latest version of the Dashware and the GoPro Quik software for desktop. So go ahead and install these two particular softwares. And once you have installed them, go to your program files. And over there, go to the GoPro folder. And you'll see GoPro desktop app. Open that up. Under that we have a folder called telemetry data, and we have a few more folders in that. The first one is called the data profile, so open that up, select all these files and copy them. Go back to your program files and now go to the Dashware folder. And under Dashware, go to the first folder, which is the data tool. Open that up. And over here also, you will see similar folders. The first one is data profile. Open that up and paste the files that we just copied. What we've done is basically we've copied the files for every GoPro model that interprets the GPS data that the camera captures, which the software can analyze. That way we can access the telemetry data for our use. And these files were actually missing in the previous version of the softwares, and that's why it was very difficult for us to use the telemetry data, and we had to rely on some other softwares like the Racerender PRO, which is a paid software and you have to buy it. But Dashware is free, the GoPro Quik software is also free. And now we have the files that we actually need in order to use the GPS data of the Fusion. So once we have all these files copied, I'll open up Dashware and I'll create a new project, and I'll select GoPro metric as my template, and we'll select the front file of the Fusion clip that we want to work upon, and choose GoPro as your data profile over here and click add. And straight away, as you can see, we have our telemetry data available to us. Previously this wasn't possible because the files that we just copied from the GoPro Quik software into the Dashware program were actually the files that were required in order to interpret or analyze the GPS data of each of those particular GoPro models, like the Hero 7 or the GoPro Fusion. Now the data that we have over here is already synced to the video and it's perfectly aligned, and the data is accurate as well. So if I play this, now after this we can export this as a video, or we can create a image sequence of the gauge file only, which we can then use in our other editing softwares like the Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro. So I'm going to create an image sequence over here. But if you want to export a video directly, what you can do is, if you have a particular clip that you have stitched in the Fusion software without trimming and maintaining the correct length of the file, you can import that particular file under the video tab over here, and then import the GPS data for that particular file from the raw front file and add it over here. So that way you'll have the GPS file and the edited clip synced perfectly, and then adjust the size and the placement of the gauges and export it as a clip. And now I'll work with the image sequence method. So all you have to do is just import all the images that were exported using the Dashware image sequence. Select the first file. Make sure you have the image sequence checked over here and then import it. And then just drag it over the Fusion clip so that it's synced to it. And then you can crop or mask the gauges and place them where you want. So I'm going to crop one layer from the left side and one from the right side and then adjust its position so that it looks fine. And after that, I'll edit it using the VR reframe plugin and then export it.